What seems like science fiction one day can be medical reality the next. Researchers constantly creating new frontiers in the treatment of rare and incurable diseases. Doctors are now calling on governments to prepare for the patient demand that inevitably follows these medical breakthroughs.
Robert Cooper says he's alive today because of a medical system that has provided access to new treatments.
You've been thrown a lifeline, really.
Robert's non-Hodgkin's lymphoma returned last year despite enduring 4 years of conventional treatment. In April, he travelled from his home in Gunnedah to Sydney's RPA to receive a new cancer-fighting therapy called CAR-T.
At the present time, they think I'm clear.
This is a type of cell therapy where a patient's own cells are taken out the body, manipulated in a laboratory, and then put back into that person.
From fighting cancer to treating kids with incurable inherited disease. For the first time, babies with spinal muscular atrophy are living past their first birthday due to breakthroughs in gene therapy.
With early diagnosis, with early treatment with gene therapy, we're now seeing these children running around at the age of 2. Extraordinary times.
A white paper reveals there are currently 2,000 human trials involving cell and gene therapies. The US medical watchdog, the FDA, is assessing between 10 and 20 new treatments each year.
So we really need to prepare ourselves for this exciting new time in medicine.
Among the recommendations to government, to establish an expert advisory group to help facilitate access to treatments here and to open an office for rare diseases to boost early diagnosis, detection and support.
Experts say up to 2 million Australians are living with a rare disease. That's about the same number of people with diabetes. Cell and gene therapies can potentially change and save lives that were once deprived of any hope.
Cell and gene therapy has the potential to cure diseases where there were no treatments before.
Gabriella Rogers, Nine News.